Big O notation is the final tool for analyzing algorithms that you need to know about before we can analyze Alice's algorithm. As we've just seen, even talking about worst-case running time can be a bit tricky if we're trying to be very precise. So we have to identify the worst-case input in detail, which can be counterintuitive, and then work through a lot of different cases. And also, as you notice, it's annoying to have to count every single step an algorithm makes. So for example, if you had two algorithms and one had a running time of 2n squared plus 23 time steps and the other one had 2n squared plus 27 time steps, you wouldn't really care about the 23 or the 27. You would say that essentially they have the same running time. So we are going to introduce a huge simplification to stating running times, and that is called Big O notation. If you've had an algorithms course before, you should already be familiar with this, but we'll review it here just to make sure you understand. So let's say we have two algorithms, algorithm A and algorithm B. And algorithm A has a running time of 3n squared minus n plus 10 for an input of size n. And algorithm B has a running time of 2 to the power of n minus 50n plus 256. So what I would like you to think about is which of these two algorithms you would prefer if you don't know anything about the input other than that you're going to get different sizes. So no other structural assumptions or anything else that you know. And I would like you to check this box if you think it's algorithm A that you should take in general, and this box if you think it's algorithm B.